Hi, this is USD CAD and today it's Wednesday, 3rd of December 2014 and the time is 21:05 GMT. I'm Sofia Stavropoulou and this is a video signal for Forex ID Academy members and FXholics Forex Signals apps users. I'm using Ichimoku Kinko here. Let's go to the monthly time frame of the pair. We see here we don't have a fresh price Tenkan-Sen cross. We see that the pair has made a bullish Kumo breakout, a very strong bullish Kumo breakout, but the last candlestick is bearish and Chiku span confirms that, and maybe it is time for a correction down to the level of the Tenkan-Sen, the red line. Although the leading Kumo is bullish and the bullish momentum is increasing. On the weekly, we don't have a fresh price Tenkan-Sen cross. On the daily, we don't have a fresh price Tenkan-Sen cross, although it looks like the pair is making an effort to go down. But all this wild bullish momentum can't be negated easily. So let's go to H4 to see if it succeeded. On H4, we see that the pair made a bullish price Tenkan-Sen cross, but Tenkan-Sen is not curved downwards. It's not angled downwards, although we had this big spike here. And the two following bullish candlesticks on H4 show that this bullish momentum is really huge. So let's see if on H1 we had a bearish Kumo breakout. We had the bearish Kumo breakout, which was not validated by Chiku span, the green line of Ichimoku Kinko here. And let's see on M30 if the picture was clearly bearish. It was clearly bearish, and on M15 we are already at the bullish correction phase, so wait patiently to see this upward move getting exhausted. And when you see a strong bearish candlestick crossing and closing below Tenkan-Sen, with Tenkan-Sen being curved downwards like you see it here, curved downwards or angled downwards, then enter short, then sell. Till then, stay out and wait. Let the pair exhaust its bullish momentum. When you see the bearish move, when you see the continuation of the fall, go down to M5, M1 and enter from there. Make sure that everything is bearish when you enter. And when you enter, place your stop loss above the Kumo on M15 and trail it going down on the next stair of the Kumo. And as for take profit target, let's go to H4. A nice first take profit target could be the upper border of the Kumo here, and then the upper border of the Kumo on the daily would be a nice next take profit target. Maybe the pair will not manage to go below to make a bearish Kumo breakout on the daily. Maybe it will lose its bearish momentum by touching the body of the Kumo, which represents support, or even it can be nailed inside the body of the Kumo and then bounce off and continue going higher. Thanks for watching and happy pips.